This could really be a reach for some creatures who are known for their incredibly short arms. Albuquerque Zoo is asking the state for a lot of money to build a new home for its four fast-growing alligators. News 13's Alex Goldsmith is live at the zoo. Alex?
Dick, the zoo's curator tells me he really wants to show off his alligators, but without some more space, they might have to be shipped off.
At the Rio Grande Zoo, you can find your favorite big cat, condor, seal, no problem. You can even catch a glimpse of a pair of saltwater crocodiles from a safe distance. But hidden in a pool behind those killer crocs, you can't see these guys. Meet four American alligators the zoo's had for nearly 4 years. The zoo originally brought in 24 of them as hatchlings.
We sent off 20-some alligators back down to Florida, and we did hold on to four of these, one male and three females.
But 8 months ago, these gators got too big for their space, and the zoo had to move them here.
He's got that tail locked and loaded, man.
They're about 5 feet long now and will outgrow this pool in less than a year.
The males are capable of growing 14 feet long, and that's a big animal. So we do need to get them out and on display or somewhere as quickly as we can.
The zoo's reptile curator, Doug Hodel, has a plan. He wants to take this blocked-off courtyard outside the reptile house and turn it into a new exhibit. Hodel's asking state lawmakers to pony up $150,000 to give these gators a new home.
We've got three walls already built. Basically, if we build a pool and a fence, we've almost got this thing opened up. All of the components are here. We have the water, we have the drain, we have the electricity, and we have the real estate.
Hodel says the zoo may have to get rid of the alligators if the project can't get funding, something he desperately doesn't want to see happen.
It's not just going to make the zoo look better, but it's going to be an educational value for the 1.5 million people that come through the gate every year.
Now, Hodel says if the project does get the green light and the funding, it could be open as early as this fall. Now, these gators aren't just eating up food. They're also eating up some cash. Hodel says they cost about $25,000 a year to feed for animals that the public doesn't get to see right now. Back to you, Dick.
All right, Alex, now if the state does not come through with the money, the zoo could try to get the project under the city's bond package, or it might ask private donors to try to cover the cost.